Good evening, everybody. It's game day 5 of the FIBA World Cup European qualifiers, and Greece face Great Britain here in Larissa, Greece, the center of Greece, in the Neapolis Arena. 5,500 people expected to fill this facility as Greece look to avenge the 9-point loss to Great Britain on game day 1. Here is the current standings of a group now that only has the 3 teams in it, with the omission of Belarus. Greece and Turkey only have 1 game in this World Cup qualification window. Great Britain have to face both teams as they search for a place, not just a place in the second round, because these 3 teams will qualify, but the results go forward. And if you want to be on that plane to the Philippines, Japan, and Indonesia, a win in every single stage of this competition is absolutely crucial. Huge task for Great Britain with a completely revamped backcourt. No Teddy Okafor, who had a career night in the win in Newcastle. No Tariq Phillip. And no Luke Nelson. Deva Van Oostrum makes a return to the GB national team. And is this the time for Deva Van Oostrum to fulfill the obvious promise that he had shown as one of the most highly rated juniors in European basketball? The home crowd are ready as Greece will be introduced. Tyler Dorsey takes his bow at home for the Greek national team. The Olympiacos guard is going to be a handful for Great Britain. Has had a stellar season so far with the legendary club Olympiacos. Nice blend here with the veteran Kostas Papanikolaou, now at 31 years old. He's been a stalwart this national team for so many years, alongside the talent of Kostas Antetokounmpo and Kalazakis, who unusually plays his basketball in Lithuania. But this team sit on top of the group and will have aspirations to make another trip and go deep in a World Cup finals. And the talent doesn't stop. The players, Coach Etudis, one of the top coaches in European history. Now we'll have the national anthems of both Great Britain and Greece, starting with Great Britain. And now the national anthem of Greece. Well, no words that I can use can tell you how much passion there is in this arena this afternoon, or local time, 8 o'clock in the evening here in Larissa. And a game for Greece, that would see them take a huge step towards qualification for the World Cup. For Great Britain, it could be a big, big victory. A 2-0 record against Greece would really, again, put them in great shape for the second round. The three officials for this evening game, Mr. Zurapovic, Mr. Marquez, and Mr. Rutsik from Bosnia, Portugal, and Montenegro, respectively, take charge of what could be a hugely contested tight battle. Single-digit games between these three countries the last three times they've met, and surprisingly for some, Great Britain would have had the biggest win as they took a 9-point victory in Newcastle. The starting lineup for Great Britain: Gabriel Lissini, Dan Clark, Miles Hessen, and where the game is going to be won and lost, Carl Wiedel and Patrick Whelan in the backcourt for Great Britain. And I don't think there's a British fan anywhere that would have predicted in this game that would have been the backcourt. But the injuries and the unavailability of the three guards, Orekepo's with the group, but he's injured. Well, cometh the hour, cometh the man, so to speak. Head coach for Great Britain, Nate Reinking, in the middle of the shot. The man on the left, Mark Studel, has taken charge of this Great Britain lineup. This is Nate Reinking's first game in the World Cup qualifiers. And the former Great Britain player now in the NBA, or in the G League, in fact, is picking up a team that has momentum. And Studel, Coach Studel, has done an absolutely tremendous job with this Great Britain national team. Greece with Tyler Dorsey, Agravanis, who led the scorers for Greece in the loss in Newcastle, Papagiannis in the center, and at 2m17 is going to be handful. Papanikolaou at the forward spot. Lazis is the other guard in the backcourt, as Greece, I think, and Coach Atoudis will look to exploit the obvious experience advantage they have in the backcourt. Well, national team basketball gives players huge opportunity, and that's what this game gives to that Great Britain backcourt. Patrick Whelan's had a marvelous season in the British Basketball League with the champion team Leicester Riders, and Carl Wiedel, well, after many years of being talked about as one of the best young players in Great Britain, having spent his formative years in Italy at 24 years old, this is his time to step up, and this is his time to try and lead Great Britain to what they hope will be a famous victory. Greece, on the other hand, at home in Loiso, which is a hotbed. The A1 team playing here has some British connections. Steve Hansel of the Shire of Birmingham played A1 basketball here for Larissa, one of the youngest clubs in A1, but a passionate hotbed of an atmosphere. Coach Atoudis is gonna try and thrive on that. Well, the Tissot countdown to tip off. We're 1 minute away from the first action in this group of World Cup qualifiers, and this is what national team basketball is all about, and this is what those players, well, they want the opportunity. Both sets of players would love to be on that flight to the Philippines, Japan, and Indonesia. A win here would be an enormous step forward in trying to reach that goal. Here we go then. Greece in the home white, Great Britain in the blue. World Cup qualifier basketball underway here in Larissa, and Greece will have a look at it in the half court. Dorsey outside, they'll look to hand off. Moses drops it inside on the pick and roll with a short roll for the jumper. Alassini keeps it alive, and that'll go to Great Britain. Alassini shows the value of his athleticism and quickness, gets back in the play, deflects it, and Agravanis cannot get it. This is going to be the story all night for Great Britain. Advance the ball under pressure. Wheedle to the handoff. Clark pops to the three-point line. Good for Clark for three. Controlled half-court offense. Dan Clark, the vet, knocks down the three. That'll settle down this Great Britain team and the nerves. Agravanis outside, will look to drop it inside. Goes on the floor against Clark. Agravanis can't get it. But Greece come out with the basketball. They go out for the three, is short. Clark comes down with a defensive rebound. And the veteran big man, after a season in the BBL, winning in transition for three, is no good. And Greece, efficiency personified, will go early pick and roll. Look it out, looks inside, no option, will go high. Agravanis against Clark again, one-on-one. Greece looking to exploit the matchup. Tries to go baseline. Clark plays good defense, forces the tough shot. Wheedle in transition. Mess. Hessen, great post up, great finish. And Great Britain with a super 5-0 start. Takes you back to 2013, where Clark and Hessen formed a huge partnership as Great Britain came within a game of the second phase of Eurobasket in Slovenia. Dorsey looking for a little space. Wheedle plays great defense. Dorsey with a step back, but fouled by Wheedle. And for all the effort for Carl Wheedle, forcing the tough shot should be enough. Forward momentum on the defense, straight through Dorsey. Dorsey will go to the free throw line as Miles Hessen shows you why they love him in Japan. Tyler Dorsey playing at home in front of this great work on the glass. Agravanis misses the putback. Olaseni's back in the game. The Great Britain dodge a bullet, but it might only be a temporary dodge. In fact, it's not. Clark acknowledges the miss. Box out. Great Britain dodged the bullet. And 7:45 to go in quarter one. And full court pressure again. Patrick Whelan with the basketball. Just has to remember what it's like to handle it against pressure. Hessen in traffic, blows the layup. Exactly what Greece will want Great Britain to do. Take a shot that Greece want them to take. Dorsey shakes it, comes off the ball screen, the roll to the inside, great pass, extra the outside. Great rotation by Great Britain. Tremendous scramble defense. Greece turned down a couple of what could have been early looks. The open three in transition. And Patrick Whelan knocks down the three, and that should give him the confidence. Agiannis kicks it back out. Dorsey goes inside. Tremendous work by Olaseni defensively. Great Britain in transition again. It's about decisions. Great one for the easy two. And Greece, on the wrong end of a 10-1 start against Great Britain, will take the timeout. Tremendous finish in transition. And Whelan goes back-to-back scores. And Atuda says, I've seen enough of this start. Let's talk it over. well, clear from Coach Adudis' timeout that some defensive transition is sadly missing. They've had good looks at the other end, though. Agravanis, although Clark played good defense, Agravanis had two good looks. On the center, his athleticism kept things alive. Great Britain show a little soft pressure. Take some time out of the shot clock. Dorsey on a straight lift. Can't get the three to go. Hessen will come down with the basketball. It's about leveling decisions for Great Britain at the moment. Hessen is fouled on the floor. Coach Ryan King would have preferred the ball given up and Great Britain set, but Hessen gets the positive with the foul. You can see the hands on the back. The whistle's already gone, and they're going to call it on the floor. Hessen from the three-point line is fouled, but will go to the line as the ball decided to rim out. Interesting to see how the front line of Great Britain, which is competitive with any in Europe, gets enough touches, gets enough opportunity to be a factor in the game, because Olaseni's had a marvelous season again in Turkey. Clark and Hessen have played many times. In fact, this front line has played on a number of occasions together. It's going to be a factor for Great Britain. And can Greece force issues in that backcourt? 12-1 start with 6:13 to go in the first quarter. Again, the pick and roll to try and get advantage. Foul on the closeout. Clark with a mismatch decides, let's take one of my fouls here. Good ball movement by Greece, though. The pick and roll just created the separation offense to defense, offensively and defensively. GB switch. Great play! And a throw down on the alley-oop. Papagiannis, all 2 meters 17, doesn't need to get off the floor much. Threw it down hard. Hessen with a tough one, with a bad one. Momentum can swing in a moment. Early post up. She goes up, Giannis off the glass for two, the big boy. Going to play deep, Papagiannis. Panathinaikos, big man. Gets back-to-back buckets. Backcourt issues again for Great Britain. Hessen puts it on the floor. Poor pass. 4-on-2 break. Great play on the block, but the great follow. And Greece, following the Adudis timeout, eat into the lead. And this is one thing you can't have. 4-on-2. Great effort by Hessen to get the block. Zero help. And Greece just outworked Great Britain. And keep that little momentum going after the timeout. Timeout. Coach Ryan King wants to talk it over. Let's see if we can get a listen. It's a great pass, but the issue for Great Britain there is that there's space for the cut. Take the space for the cut away, the pass never happens. But Papagiannis is... it's going to be at the bookends of this Greek lineup. Comes off Whelan's foot. And Greece are going to go after this GB backcourt. Quality of pass, quality of patience, decision making. Doesn't have to look pretty, just got to advance it. It's a 6-0 run here for Greece as they answer the 12-1 start for Great Britain. Gravanis drops it inside, a little bit too cozy. No space for the pass. And Great Britain get a dodge another bullet. This is where Great Britain have to get into something offensively a little quicker. Whelan goes hard to the glass, has it knocked away. Nice pass for the dunk! And the throwdown in transition, make that an 8-0 run for Greece as they get right back in this. Essen off the glass for a quick two is good. Dorsey on the step back as they try and unravel on the pick and roll. Great defensive rebound. Hessen everywhere. Olaseni inside out with Clark. Ball movement. Whelan comes off the pick. Gets his feet set for three. He is short. Defensive rebound is just owned by Papagiannis. Great pick and roll. They're going to pick and roll you all game. Little handoff inside outside. Agravanis, little shake, gets to the ring for two is good. .320 to go in quarter one, and now we've got a game on. Hessen doesn't think about it, throws the air ball up though. Agravanis, feet set, lines up the three, is short. Defensive rebound belongs to Patrick Whelan. And Great Britain with a shallow roster are going to have to spend more time with the ball. Whelan needs a pass. Clark will kick it on. Inside option for Hessen, one-on-one with no help. Inside out kick. With a little jump shot from the foul line is good, and that is so much more about how Great Britain will have to play this game to get the win. Great ball movement. Everyone gets a touch. Ball doesn't stick. Dorsey. Inside out. Dorsey gets it again. Gets to the foul line. Little flip. Giannis for three. For long. Two is good. And the 2 meter 17, 24-year-old Panathinaikos big man can let it go from deep and knocks down the long two. Hessen again with the aggressive, ripped it through and went. And again, much better decision with no help, space to attack. So the big man, Georgios Papagiannis, sits down. Devon Vanuschen steps into the game for Great Britain. Olaseni, starved at the basketball at the moment. Gabe Olaseni. Olaseni has to get touches. If he doesn't get touches, he'll go looking for it like he did then. He's not a veteran of some of the best leagues in Europe. Without having the ability to play, needs the basketball. The Great Britain five. Whelan comes off a stagger. They know they turn it over, but Whelan recovers it. Olaseni on the inside for two. Deep touch, deep score. Good hustle, Patrick Whelan. who looks like he's been a national team player for a while, the way he's performing out there at the moment for the Great Britain national team. And then you realize he just needs that experience too. Just gets suckered into it. There's the foul. Larenzakis. What it says on the tin is that Gabo Lasani can play this game 10 feet in. He is at the highest level. Give him space, he'll hold it. 18 to 13. That's a blocking foul. Hessen picks up the personal. Now, these World Cup windows, I know it's a little tough for the players. It's a long season. They're out there on the floor literally at the end of June. But it's national team basketball. This is where they want to be. Showed in the middle is like showing him a little freebie. Poporetsu gets the easy two. Weedle. Weave action. Vanushuk moves it on. Hessen. Ball sticks. We got a foul away from the basketball. See, Olesen needs the basketball. They've got to give him a look. Gets the positive of the foul. But would have loved to get the deep catch. Great Britain. Weedle pulls up from the foul line, is long. Van Oostrom hunts it down, doesn't get it. Greece with a 4-3-on-2 break. The extra pass was there, but they turn it down. Larenzakis in the lane. Hessen comes up with a steal. Great Britain go the other way. Easy two on the break. Oh, what a blown layup. It's Elagani Khan. And Olaseni's going to clear up the mess. Goes up for two. Latia Ugani missed the easy layup, almost frustrated with himself, took the far too quick three, and Gabe Olesen bows him out with the great work on the offensive glass. Perchu is good. Whistle on the play. And Greece just stretching the inside. Petru, and that's, I think that foul's going to be, well, it's on Hessen, it's a little tough. The foul's not on the shot, the foul's on the rebound situation. Clark steps back in as both teams try to find a way to keep everybody fresh. After the 12-1 start, a 17-8 response by Greece with the free throws to come because Great Britain are in the team fouls. I think Hessen's a little bit, could have gone either way. Kostas Antetokounmpo on the free throw line. With Tony Parker's Asphalt in France. Great Britain will hold, well, if they get the defensive rebound, hold the ball for one shot. So Great Britain with the 20-19 advantage and wanting to get the last shot. Olesen will come high for the ball screen. Will gets away, a little push off, steps back for the two, blows it. And that'll do it for quarter one. And Great Britain lead it 20-19 after a super start. Greece responded, and we've got a one-point game. There's the confirmation. Great Britain here in La Lissa have a 20-19 advantage. is the best plays. That's how Great Britain started the game. Clark gets one look at the bucket, knocks it down. The big man, Georgios Papagiannis, had a spell in that first quarter where he just dominated. After the dunk, gets the nice little jump hook. And I think if you were going to be analytical about it, Olaseni needs more touches for Great Britain, and that might be, you know, just the key for the Greeks to stop the ball going inside. And with the issues that Great Britain have in the backcourt, that will also be a problem. But Gabe needs the basketball. Greece have probably got more shots that you'd say shots they want. If you want to watch and stay in touch with all the games on the World Cup, get that Courtside 1891 app. So Great Britain, after the super stop, pegged back by Greece in that first quarter, they'll have possession at the start of this second quarter. Devon Van Oostrum, as we said before the game, is this where Devon Van Oostrum fulfills that promise? Not on that showing, throws up the air ball, forces the early shot, early in the offense, wide open. Papetriou can't get it to drop. Great work on the glass by Patrick Winnan. He kept by Oleg Lattier-Ogunle. He gets the work done, and Great Britain will get the possession. The dilemma for Great Britain is Van Oostrum's obviously their most accomplished guard. Cavell Begley-Williams in the block. Give him a touch early. See what he has today. They turn that down. That's going to be a Great Britain basketball. Great work again. The work rate by Lottier Ogunle is exceptional. And to an extent got walked underneath for a little bit. But the ball stays with Great Britain with a new 14. Inside touches. The only thing you've got to say I'm missing from Great Britain at the moment. And he goes up off the glass, gets the two, tough move. That's a, even though it was a tough move, it was in his time. Wasn't rushed, wasn't forced. Salakis on the outside will move it, goes inside. Petru goes with a jump hook, tough move. If you let him go to the middle, he has too many tools in the locker. Van Oostrum, ball's on the floor again. Clark turns it over. Nice move to the inside. There's just too much space, letting him go to the middle. And Yanni Papaletsu just knows how to finish. Greece with a chance to find themselves in the lead. Step back three is off. Defensive rebound. Bigby Williams comes down with it. How long will Great Britain play without Olusegun? Skip pass. Van Oostrum, ball fake, steps into the two-point range, knocks it down. Again, in the same way the last move, Great Britain get a shot that they're under control with and open it out to a three-point lead. Vasilakis will move it on. The three is off, defensive rebound. Patrick Winning pulls it in. Van Oostrum, is that little jumper going to give him some confidence? Turns down the pick. And again, get the inside with a scoop shot, doesn't get it to go. Vasilakis inside, forces it. Comes up short, Great Britain with a chance to run. Wheeling in transit, in transition off the glass for two, another forced one. Interesting dilemma for coach Ryan King. Dwayne Lettier, Ronnie is obviously his energy. He wants to make things happen. But decision making, got to pick a time, got to pick a place. Greece at 57%. Great Britain at 47% from two. Cavell, Big B Williams. In the Dominican Republic. With the Indios de San Francisco club. This is an interesting lineup for Great Britain. Still holding the lead. That's a bonus for coach Rankin. Big Williams can't get the two to go. Just under seven to go in the half. Tempo slows. Dorsey, little hesitation, drops it inside. Tunis wants the unsportsmanlike. I'm not sure he's going to get it. To be fair, he should get it. Van Oostrum, no chance of... And the referee, quite rightly, is going to call the unsportsmanlike. It's got to be a legitimate play. They're going to review it, which is exactly the right thing to do. I think the question will be, is that a legitimate attempt to play the ball? And to Tacumbo through the elbow after. Yeah, they're going to stay with the unsportsmanlike, which I think is correct. Middle penetration again, the undoing of Great Britain. Costas Antetokounmpo on the free throw line. Doesn't make the first. So Greece on the sideline, new 14, 6:44 to go in the half. Dorsey takes the pick. Inside, outside, the extra pass. Dorsey started the play, gets the open three and just fills it up. That's Greek basketball. Move the ball, share the ball. Create the open shot for your teammate and you shoot good percentages. Clark lines up the three, is long. Not a sharp design, should we say. I think Greece just stepped out of bounds. Wry smile. ...6:05 in the half. Great Britain and Greece locked at 25. The man of the game so far, Papagiannis, steps back in. Kane from out of bounds. One of those unfortunate ones. Van Oostrum. Olesen, he gets a touch. First time he's had a touch in the block. Far side of the ring is blocked. 2m17 is just 2m17 too much. Tried to use the ring to protect it. Greece again, sideline pick and roll. They turn it down and post. Oh, nice flare. The execution was great, but the shot is off. Great work on the glass. A tough fadeaway is good. That's a Lakis. Whistle on the play. So Greece lead it for the first time in a very, very long time. There's the blocking foul. This is tough. The lean away. Great arc on it. Nothing but string. Van Oostrum. Whistle away from the basketball. Another holding foul. Out top, Hessen back in the game, steps through, gets the two. Carl Weidel, hours of fundamentals, gives you that move. Nice step through for the two. Another tight 27, ball's deflected away. Hessen's after that, showing a little bit of pace. Great execute, great effort to the inside for two is good, and that's just outwork your opponent time. And Weidel has back-to-back hoops. Referees call it consistent with a blocking foul. That'll be Great Britain's second team foul. This is just outwork your opponent. Vasilakis didn't want to get on the floor. Carl Weidel finishes the play. Great Britain lead at 29-27. Tyler Dorsey has it. Pick and roll again. They go inside to the throwdown. And again, there's too much of a seam on the help on the weak side for Great Britain. Olesen outside the three-point line. Clark on the pick and pop. Moves it on. Olesen from the foul line. Foul line in. Olesen's top class. Great Britain with a nice lineup. Back to the starters. Dorsey turns the corner, flips it. Agravanis turns down the three. As Alakis inside out. Whistle on the play. Clark will pick up his second foul. He's claiming a dive. Agravanis will wander to the three throw line. Just take a look. On the wrist. But Agravanis. Well, oh, number of films lately with world-class basketball players performing in them. He has a role. He made the obvious foul on the wrist, but made a lot of it. But the man of the game at the moment, Georgios Papagiannis for Greece, the 2m17, 24-year-old, is just having a game. 8 points, five boards, four from five from the field. Changes shots. Agravanis makes the free throw. Ties at the 31, chance to give Greece the lead with just over 3.5 to go in the first half. Three from three from the free throw line. Wheatle again. Etudis has decided whenever we can, we're going to get up the floor and put pressure on this Great Britain backcourt. So they go long with a pass, got to get it over, and do. Ten on the possession. Wheatle, still plenty of time. Gets to the ring and one. Great composure, super move on the end of it, the two. Handles it, takes the contact, that second step gets into the ring. And Carl Wheatle will go to the free throw line. Again, post up option. Avanis going to work, kicks it, will ball screen and pop. Great Britain switch it. The deep three on the end of the clock is short. Hessen will come down with a defensive rebound. And he is fouled. Agravanis takes one for the team. Not sure why he took one for the team. And Greece in the bonus, in the penalty. Timeout. Last 3 minutes of this first half, and Coach Etudis wants to talk it over. Let's see if we can catch this. Changes in the backcourt for Greece coming out of the timeout. Nikas Gikas will check in. Approaching that veteran status. Gikas, 31. But Coach Etudis is looking to really push home what he thinks is the advantage he has in that backcourt and the pressure he can put on. The pick and roll is being dealt with by Great Britain. They're switching most things. But he's going to really spend 40 minutes trying to make this British backcourt struggle as much as they can. Interesting to see if Coach Ryan King comes out with anything from the timeout. He's on the free throw line. Whether he shows a little bit of pressure, has fouls to give. Makes the second. Looks a little 2-2-1. Just to delay and slow down, no trap. Back to straight man. Gikas looks inside. The battle going on in there. Papanetsu tries to get to the middle again. Oh, they give him the open look. Knocks down the two. Tough play. The veteran ties it at 34 apiece. Two to go in the half. Olaseni outside the three-point line will hand off. Dorsey picks the pocket. Should be an easy two. Oh, Olaseni goes up to block. No way was he giving that one up. It's just a tough foul. Stay on the floor defensively, because Ioni Papaletru is going to knock it down. Tyler Dorsey on the free throw line. Papaletru sits down. Papanikolaou steps in. Last 2 minutes of what's been a fascinating first half. Both teams in the penalty for the last 2 minutes. Crucial for both teams. It's Greek trying to push this advantage, open it to a 6 to an 8 point game. That's going to undo the work Great Britain have done in this first half so far. They've just got to be smart going into the half on the road here in La Lissa. Whelan sees the opportunity to penetrate. The sending extra pass, wide open. The three is no good. Wide open look, can't complete. Papagiannis comes down with a defensive rebound. Ball's knocked away. Ball will stay with Greece. Jamal Anderson gets his first action. Defensively, one of the best players in the British Basketball League. Open three. No good. Oh, the Seni comes down. Nice outlet. That's going to be a blocking foul. Hessen will go to the free throw line. Gikas will hold his chin, but never had position. And Miles Hessen will find himself on the free throw line. Chance to tie the game at 36. Friendly roll. And Hessen goes 2 for 2. We've got a new ball game with 1:30 to go in the first half. Great Britain extend the defense. Greece passed through it. Petrides. Petrides on the floor. Looks like he wants this one. Attacks it. Has it knocked away. Ball comes off the Greek leg. Eleftheris, Botcharidis. Well, that was the call. Opportunity for him to penetrate. Great Britain will take the timeout with 1:11. Coach Ryan King, Dan Clark played together on the Great Britain Olympic team in 2012. Ranking now in the role of head coach. Got a huge opportunity here. Tied at 36, 1:11 to go. See if we can pick up the timeout. again, pressure on the inbound. Wheeler advances it. Olaseni on the roll. Had the look. Wheeler into the ring. Doesn't get it, but Olaseni clears up the mess. Goes up, back up for two. Cleared out really well. Wheeler would be disappointed he didn't make the two, but Olaseni just cleans up the mess. And Great Britain go to two up. Kept alive. Wheeler, chance to run. Drops it inside. Stolen. Pocket picked. They'll review it, I think. Great finish. Super finish under pressure. Great read. Watch Olaidis. This is going one way. Throws that one down. Should be just an out one. Nothing exceptional about what Carl Wheadle tried to do. Looked like an attempt at the basketball. But Olaidis to complete the three-point play. Does. Great Britain will have 17.3 seconds to re-establish the lead going into the half. Great Britain bring Clark back for the last possession. Struggling to beat the pressure, getting it in. Just about beat the five count. Wheadle, Olaseni looking for the ball screen. Hessen spins, foul line, in traffic, gonna travel. Drew three, got a kick. There you see all five white shirts in the picture. There's the travel. That means on either wing, Hessen would have had two open shooters. Decided to try and force it up. Greece have 3.5 to get something away. Dorsey puts it on the floor. Stops, pops, drops short for three. And that'll do it for a first half. That has been World Cup basketball at its best. There's confirmation. Greece lead it 39-38 at the half. Well, statistically, Greece was 63% from two. Great Britain only shooting 25% from the three-point line. They made the first three of the game, only made one since. Rebound and everything pretty close, as you'd expect it to be with a one-point game. Hessen has nine, Olaseni with on eight, and most of those have been clearing up the mess. Papaletsu was excellent, and Papagiannis changed the game in that first half. Just get a look. Game opened out with a trademark three from Clark. And Papagiannis had a trademark dunk because he had two of those in that first half. And you have to be, the plan for Greece, you have to be clear, get up the floor and make that Great Britain backcourt work for every single minute of the 20 in the first half. They did. And you've got to say, Great Britain stayed with it. Carl Wheadle in particular did a really nice job being safe with the basketball. If they stay safe with it, they're going to get enough shots. If they force it too much, Greece are just going to be so too efficient for them. Papaletsu just showed exactly what he is, the 28-year-old Panathinaikos, small forward, lead the scorers for Greece. That was just exceptional. So, that first half showed what we said at the beginning. Games between Greece and Great Britain in recent years have all been close affairs. Greece won an overtime game in Leicester. Great Britain win a 9-point game after being 5 down at the half in Newcastle in the first part of qualifying for this World Cup. And they lost a close one in Greece in the qualifiers for the last one. Well, again, before the game, we talked about opportunities, and Carl Wiedel has taken that.
Representing your people and their dreams, the colorful faces in the streets, the screaming fans in the stands. It's time to make your move. All eyes on you, all hope, all heart. Because when you win for all.
Sensational stuff here. And Bosnia-Herzegovina, but Gavages again. This time, he is not going to be denied.
Now it's a 3-on-3. Going all the way through and scoring. Vojtsa. Was that through the legs of his opponent?
Using up the seconds. Rosenthal draws the switch. Tough three. Jumper Vene knocks it down. It's good. Sinisander Vene. That is why he was the leading scorer in window number one. That is why they got him the ball with the clock winding down.
Ogban Ulubai, his first three. Now the steal. Right at the buzzer. Oh, he made it! He made it, are you kidding me?
He's up to 18 points, 10 rebounds, double-double for him. And thrown up, acrobatic move from Lowe. Sensational move from Mauro Lowe, the Alba Berlin star, now a star for Germany.
And alley-oop! And Papayannis flushes it and will go to the line for a potential three-point play. That's a good connection there with Papanikolaou the second time.
The Czechs need a score. Pulpan crosses over, kicks it, three to win it. It's good! Penica buries the three. Is that going to be enough to win this game? There's 1.2 left.
They throw it above the ring. That'll do it. They take the three. They're talking game margins now.
Well, he made 1-3 in the first half, but he's not made another. Oh, how about that? Joel Parra. Look at this. Around the back.
And great hustle by Aldali. Kunjir fakes. Bounce pass into Kamaja. Are you kidding me? What a powerful move from number 28. Just like he does for Galatasaray.
just about to start this second half then. Coach Ryan King must be pleased with the way his team has competed in that first half. The full-court pressure from Greece has been the fact that they've dealt with it reasonably well. Turnovers, only 7 turnovers in the first half for Great Britain against that full-court pressure. Patrick Whelan impresses again. 2 seasons ago, Lev Gold in Spain. Great season for the Leicester Riders in the British Basketball League. And here he is in a World Cup qualifier playing a major role. What a great story for him. Virtue will reverse the basketball. Dorsey inside touch again. Essen's going to force him baseline. That's much better. The help comes. They're going to throw it out of the post. Vetchup on the drive. Throws it across the defense that time. And Wietel comes up with the steal. Wietel looks at it. Clark on the trowel for 3. Is short. Defensive rebound. Those are the shots. Essen missed one earlier in the game. Clark misses that one. Wide open threes. You've got to knock them down. Agravanis outside. Great Britain trying to force to the outside. Pavetru goes to the inside, looks for a pass, finds one. Dorsey attacks it, gets to the lane, takes the tough one, doesn't get it to go. And that man, all 2 meters, 17. Papagiannis gets the 2. Good defensive effort by Great Britain, made Greece really work for it. Wheadle, Oluseni, mid-range, way off. Greece pace of game at the moment. Dorsey looking inside, no option. Oluseni. Dorsey gets the handoff, floats it inside, no help, easy 2. Highlight time. They just slow you down, stand you still, and then someone cuts hard. And on that occasion, Papagiannis gets the dunk. Great Britain a little flat here. Wheadle moves it on. Essen tries to ignite. Comes up short. Great Britain might need the early timeout if this continues. Not just down this end, but down the other end. They've had nothing. Attudis just wanted him to shoot the ball coming out of the foul. Clark picks up his 3rd. Dilemma for Ryan King on the back of a poor start for Great Britain. Pavetru with the pull-up 2 is sweet. Go at the man with the 3 fouls. Gets the 2, and Greece have opened out a 7-point lead. Biggest lead of the game for them. Whelan down the lane, off the glass. Essen is just active on the boards. He gets fouled. Essen is the first man on the move, gets the offensive rebound, is fouled by Agravanis. Second foul for Demetrius Agravanis. Miles Essen needs these. Anderson checks in. Great Britain decide to sit Clark on 3 fouls. And it's just screen away, move off the ball, drag the defense. Anderson was late on the help, but really broke it up well. Stayed active. Weedle in transition. It's blocked. There's going to be a whistle on the play. They're going to get to the free throw line. Georgia's Papagiannis. Let's have a look. Well, I think the block was clean, but a lot of contact on the arm with the other side of the body. Weedle makes the first. Great Britain trying to weather the storm of a slow start to this third quarter. Bouchardis gets it over the half line with the pass. It's a big pick and roll. Petru. Agravadis. Out the Greek coach Emmanuel. Petru. Papagiannis with the pick and roll. The help has to come. Hessen takes the tough one. Olaseni cleaning up the mess. Gets blocked. Dorsey. Off to the races, has to back it out, loses the handle. Bogolidis in the lane, will kick. Giannis going to work on the inside, goes to the middle, has it knocked away. Hessen, chance to run. That's going to be a double dribble. Greece trying to stretch the lead, trying to give themselves some breathing space. It's all the action before the Agravanis three. Hessen had to go help. Then he gets the long closeout. And again, Papagiannis comes up with another positive stat with a block. Papalechu goes upstairs. Giannis pulls it down. Dorsey has a look at what he has. Gets to the foul line. It's great effort by Weedle. That's defense. Dorsey stops and pops and knocks down the three. 3.2 seconds on the clock. Great Britain forced to take another timeout. They led by 11, then they trail by 10. And to an extent, that play sums up the difference. Weedle played great defense. Dorsey's trying to force the issue. Doesn't force the issue. Backs it out, gets a little separation, gets the shot he wants. Great Britain, key moments in the game. Ranking with a timeout and some work to do. You can analyze this and look at it in all sorts of different ways. The pressure from Greece up the floor. But at the end of the day, the margin is the field goal percentages. Both teams shooting rough, like literally the same number of shots. You know, Greece shooting the ball 50% against the 38% from Great Britain. Both teams poor from the three-point line, 20 and 24%. Greece 65% from two, hence the 10-point lead. Shots they want, not shots that are being forced. Weedle wraps it, open three in the corner, turned down, penetration, kick, Weedle, extra pass is turned over, watch out. Agravadis on the runway for the throwdown. Great Britain have to stop the bleeding, and Greece smelling the victory. Looking to extend the defense. Hessen puts it on the floor again in traffic. Anderson puts it on the floor, kicks. The tough three from the corner is short. Whelan can't get it to go. And Greece defensively just stepped it up here. Dorsey turns down the pick and roll, wraps it, extra pass, no movement. Dorsey gets it back for three, is short. Hessen comes down with the defensive rebound, got a whistle on the play. Carl Wiedle on the floor, it was out of shot, didn't see it. There's the closeout by Wiedle. Can't see his legs and his feet. There's a little contact on the landing. I don't think Dorsey changes his action. Nope. Agravanis on the runway, throws it down. Caught the elbow, or the elbow caught Wheatle as Dorsey was finishing the shot. Referee calls no foul or no contact. Wheatle gets to his feet. He'll have to leave as the medical staff have entered the floor. Referee's going to look at it. Again, technology. Such an asset. Just in case they missed anything. I really don't think they did. Wiedel closes out. Little contact on the arm. And Dorsey, watch Dorsey's eyes here. He doesn't take his eyes. And it just comes down in his action. Catches Wiedel in the face, which would have been painful because of the, in slow-mo, doesn't do it justice. As in the speed of the contact, would have been hard. Yeah, Dorsey didn't change his eye line. I don't think there was any question that he was looking to make the contact. Again, Greece trying to turn the screw ever tighter. Backcourt pressure's been there from minute one. Hessen fires up a quick three and he's way short. Greece again into the weave with the ball screen. Dorsey pick and pop. Giannis with the two is good. Shot out of what they run, and the percentage gets better and better all the time for Greece. For Van Oostrum. Whelan, Oluseni, getting the point errors. He's not going to be effective at the moment. Just about clears up extra pass. Whelan puts it on the floor. Down to 3 seconds. Have to take the quick one. Great work by Oluseni on the glass. The extra pass. Hessen puts it on the floor. The open three. Van Oostrum. Sorry. Whelan knocks down the three. And Oluseni gets rewarded for the tremendous effort on the glass. Whelan needed that one. Great Britain needed that one. Dorsey toes the line for the long two. Greece getting shots out of what they run at the moment. Their defense is forcing Great Britain to make plays. Van Oostrum, hard show, keeps the ball down the same side, puts it on the floor. Popetu, great pass, super pass, and Hessen with a throwdown. Great read by Miles Hessen, great find by Devin Van Oostrum. Last 3 minutes of the third. Dorsey off the ball screen. Giannis thinks about the long two, turns it down, foul on the plate. Great Britain just about hanging in here, 12 down. as Greece try to do what Greece do week in, week out. They're going to talk about, was this, did he toe the line? Yes, he did. Have to hang tough now, Great Britain, down 12, about 11. The table gave us three, the referees, I think, wanted to correct. Papanikolaou will inbound. Whenever you need a pass or a two or something, Papayannis is the man. Game day five of these World Cup qualifiers. Van Oostrum feels a little pressure again. He's felt pressure the minute he's been on the floor. Big Wee Williams will dive to the ring, doesn't get a look. Just about recovered by Hessen, and then they get the foul. Defensively, this Greek team is just forcing Great Britain to areas of the floor where they're just not effective. It's always an issue, national team basketball. Your offensive stuff is not as honed in as club basketball as such. And defense, as the Greeks are playing it, is a factor, big factor. Back cut, turned over. Papanikolaou penetrates, kick, the open three is good. Botolidis has looked better and better the longer this game goes on. 14-point advantage now. Dangerous, dangerous time for Great Britain. Greece trying to really stretch now. Van Oostrum, a lot of dribble, no move from Great Britain. Van Oostrum tries to force it. Hassan can't get it to go, foul on the plate. Ochoidis picks up the personal. Hessen bowled. Van Oostrum out there. Just about held enough space. Cannot leave the perimeter that wide open. Seven from 11 from Miles Hessen on the free throw line. Just hanging around Great Britain, 13 down, 150 to go. What they wouldn't give for a run at the end of this quarter. Agravanis is off. Antetokounmpo on the glass and a throwdown. Outworked, out active everybody. Van Oostrum. It's Hessen in the block, in traffic, is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line. And this Greek defense, even in situations like this, nothing easy. They're not going to let you get into any rhythm. Hessen's going to have to earn them from the line. One on three on the glass, Antetokounmpo. Kostas Antetokounmpo. Hessen needs both. Yeah. second is good. Greece won't rush now. They'll try and execute. Looking for the open look, wide open. Dodged a bullet, Great Britain, the missed three. Van Oostrum chases it down, gives it up. Weedle back in the game, looking none the worse. Clark back in the game. Important time for Great Britain. Van Oostrum in the lane, poor shot. Dorsey leads the break, nice pass, easy two. Papanikolaou gets out and runs. Missed layup under pressure. Again, another forced one for Great Britain. They need a run. Great Britain, Greece are not going to give them one. 28.3 seconds to go in the third. Dorsey gets to the K, is fouled. Dorsey's running the game here. The tempo he wants, options he wants. Having fun. Goes to the free throw line, both teams in the penalty. Dorsey sits. And Dorsey's having a game. Larrazakis checks in for Greece. Again, they're up the floor. Gonna make Carl Weedle take time out of the clock. Great Britain trying to hold for the last shot. Trying to get some momentum going into the fourth quarter. Van Oostrum drops it inside, out of bounds. And they hammer home the advantage with a half court. The third quarter has belonged to Greece. And Gikas drops it. And they have a 21 point, 69 to 49, 48 point advantage. It's party time here in Larissa. Greece at 71% from two. Their three-point percentage helped a lot by the last second shot. Great Britain down at 42 and 23, only 61% from the free throw line. The pressure has just worn down this Great Britain team, and there's still a quarter to go. And why wouldn't the second half start with one of the stories of the game? Georgios Papayannis with the throwdown, followed in by Papaletsou's two. And Greece just dominated. Agravanis joined the party in that third quarter. And as the half progressed, more and more open looks, more and more execution for Greece, for each other. And defensively, they were just exceptional. And there's that end of the quarter, underlying the supremacy they have at the moment. Nothing but string. Ikas from the halfway line for three. Whatever angle you take, if you wanted to hit the man while he was down, that's exactly what they just did. Got to balance this now, Great Britain. They have a game on Sunday against Turkey, where if they get the win at home, they split with them. If they don't come back in this game, they'll split with Greece. Points difference important, as it always is in group play. Olaseni to the baseline for two. Back in the game after a fair amount of time on the bench. Rokolidis takes the pick and roll. Arizakis takes a look, goes deep. Oh. You have to make the man with the ball put it on the floor, otherwise they have too many options. Van Oostrum drops it inside. Olaseni, extra pass. The two is good for Whelan. And Great Britain share the basketball. Nice lift, open three is good. Bokaridis lifted, the defense stayed. Great find, easy three. We've got a 22-point game as Greece start to put on a demonstration. Great post. Coach Adidas does not stop coaching. He's demanding. That's why his team is where it is. Weedle. Whelan is blocked. Got to move the defense. Aranzakis gives it up. Extra pass. Bokaridis attacks the space. And then everybody gets outworked by Katsalakis. Well, we said before the game, it's a different and a difficult period to get into shape and play for. There's the miss. There's the unopposed rebound. Great Britain continue to guard people without the ball. Yet to see anyone without the ball score. Two things here for Coach Ryan King. They have a game on Sunday. They're going to come out of this game at the very least. This is going to be a mountain to get back in this one. But they have to find some positives to take out of this. Hessen has 14 points, over 77 rebounds. Van Oostrum has 4 assists. Essen has his 14 points, 3 from 9 shooting, and 8 from 13 from the line, 10 and 6 rebounds, putting in a shift again. Olaseni on 5 for 9 from the floor. Weedle has 10 points and Whelan has 10 for Great Britain. For Greece, Agravanis and Dorsey have 12 and 13. Papagiannis has 14 and Papaletru has 13. People contributing across the roster at both ends of the floor. The penetration with the ring protection is tough. 24-point margin. Great Britain trail. We're going to get a 5-second call and the 32 minutes of just pressure. No one's trying to steal the ball from Carl Weedle. It's just pressure. And now with 8 to go, the pressure begins to really bear dividend. Petrolidis gets it into the half court. Greece on the move again. Papanikolaou out top will take the ball screen. Antetokounmpo will dive. Flyby, and the three is nothing. And that'll be a shot clock violation. Larrazakis. Carl Weedle at the moment, I think, is showing those every sign of the pressure just beginning to become an effort for him. Just about getting it over the halfway line. Can't not advancing the ball into areas where he needs to get things going. He's done a great job so far for his country. Here's Whelan. Drops it inside. Olaseni spins. Hassan tries to save, but they turn it over. Greece again at the races. Antetokounmpo, watch out. Throws it down for two. Fouled on the three, will go to the free throw line. Clark with the offensive rebound. Hassan inside, he's fouled, gets the drop. Chance to close this to a 20-point game. Six, and points difference is important, don't forget. Greece will be looking to stretch this margin as much as possible. If it comes down to a points difference to the scenario to decide who makes the World Cup, every single point can matter. Hassan completes the three-point play. 6:50 to go. Petrolidis into the half court. Well, they take the long three, it's short. Defensive rebound is Hessen. Drops it off to Weedle. who can't complete, had no angle to finish, going the other way, going upstairs, and to the gumbo! At speed, hit the runway, throws it down. Whelan pulls it up for three, doesn't get the drop. Antetokounmpo working at both ends of the floor. Comes down with a defensive rebound. Could be a very long 6 minutes here. Greece trying to literally turn the screw. Whelan gives it up. Hessen stops and pops the three, drops it. Chiridis off the glass. If you're going to show him that way, you can't give him a lane to the hoop. Great Britain will, I think, will take the timeout. They trail this one, 82-60. And a big 5.5 minutes, not in terms of probably the result, in terms of the win and the loss. But you cannot be on the wrong end of a blowout where qualification could come down to points difference. Now, the other way of looking at this in terms of head-to-head scenarios, Great Britain won by 9. In the corresponding fixture in Newcastle. They get it back into that region. That's more doable than looking at the win and the loss. 22-point margin. It's still a tough one to get it back to a points difference scenario. And as we've said on a few occasions, especially at this time of the year, players that played for Great Britain, that played in the British League, finished at the latest in the middle of May. It was only a couple of weeks ago that the Greek Championship and playoffs finished with Olympiakos and Panathinaikos playing off. And 8 of the 12 from those two clubs. 82-60. Patrick Whelan has his pocket picked. Easy two. Galazakis with the quick hands, the steal and the two. Weedle to the glass. Crowd liked it. Weedle throws it down hard. It's hard to silence a Greek crowd when they're 22 up, but Weedle just did it. Open three, they share the ball beautifully. Absolute beautiful basketball. And Gazalakis with his feet set just buried the three. Here's the replay. Antetokounmpo wanted to block it, but Weedle was up quick. And Antetokounmpo realized he was going to be in too many pitches. Beautiful ball movement. Asalakis had a clean sight of the basketball. Beautiful find. Open three. The other way. Great Britain fill it up. Hessen with the three. And the third quarter has just destroyed Great Britain's opportunity in this game. A 30-10. Third quarter. We said a two this would be looking to push in that third quarter. It's where Great Britain really won their game in Newcastle. 30-10. The game's there and it's gone. 4:15 to go. 87-65. And Kostas Papanikolaou will sit. Replaced by Lomsis. Kostas Lucas, interesting spectator. And Great Britain fans become an interesting spectator as Jaden Dallaire gets his first look at international basketball, the Stanford graduate. Three is off, defensive rebound pulled in. Van Oostrom. Hessen looking to force it. Goes off guard, can't get it to drop. 4-on-3 break. Antetokounmpo blows the two. And Dallaire gets his first stat with a defensive rebound. And one. Oh, can't get the finish. Cavell Bigby Williams will have to go and earn them on the free throw line. They had a great career at Stanford. Started his last two seasons. Got one more year of college eligibility. Will be in San Diego next season. The open three is no good for Larenzakis. Weedle. Hessen fires up the three. It's not a lot. And the game beginning to peter out. Greece have the win. Now it's about margins. Antetokounmpo thinks about, takes the three, is short. Van Oostrom will go to the free throw line. Crowd having fun here. It's their only World Cup qualifier for Greece in this window, with no Belarus in the World Cup competition anymore. And a 20-point margin. It's party time in Lalissa. 5,500 people. Is no good. Defensive rebound. Bigby Williams pulls it down, gives it up. Poor pass. Bigby Williams can't hold on. Greece don't like the numbers, so Zakis pulls it out. Kasalakis, the 32-year-old veteran, says, give me the ball, I got the college kid on me. Tries to go up against Dallaire and try and really bully him, but Dallaire holds his ground. Antetokounmpo sits. Greece are up, 19. 2 minutes to go, 5 seconds on the possession. Lonsis will inbound the basketball. The long two is no good. Offensive rebound. They get another look at a three. Also steps into the two. Can't get it to go. Surely Great Britain will look to get Leclerc a look from the three-point line. Weedle knocks down three. This will be a career night as a senior for Carl Weedle. 15 points personal for him. Agravanis for the easy two. Just blew past the defense. Vanusham turns it over. Lutsis gets the two. Elsis with it, steal and the coast-to-coast layup. 20-point game. Vanusham stops and pops, is short. And the crowd enjoying it. Greece enjoying this last 40 seconds of what's been a professional, let's say professional, high-level performance by the Greek national team. Nice pass to the inside. Agravanis off the glass for two. Too big, too strong, too everything. Great Britain started this game so well with the 12-1 scoreline, sharing the ball, taking the open look. And then the Greek defense, as much as anything else, has just worn them down. Whistle on the play. Greece will take a 3-1 record to the second round, and that is huge. That's the only loss to Great Britain, two wins over Turkey. And that puts them in a very, very strong position to start the second round. They're going to run this one down. Greece withstood a great start from Great Britain. Coaches shake. And Greece have taken care of business here. They get the win over Great Britain, 93-71. Professional with a capital P for Greece. They finish the first round group with a 3-1 record to carry forward. Great Britain have to regroup and play Turkey on Sunday. Well, stats-wise, 71% from two, exceptionally high. Neither team shot the three ball particularly well. Great Britain's woes compounded by only 65%. And every stat was tight in the first half. And then 17 turnovers don't help the cause. 39-34 on the glass. And Greece just opened this out. Agravanis was exceptional, as he was in Newcastle. Papagiannis really did. Was the rock that this performance was built on. Dorsey was exceptional at the point. In fact, the Greek backcourt was exceptional because they just employed the game plan of Coach Atoudis. Make Great Britain work for every possession. And the game became easier and easier as they were rewarded for the effort at the defensive end. Tremendous performance by Greece. So that's what it does to the Group B table. 3-1 record. Turkey and Great Britain locked on 1-2. That's how important the game is on Sunday. Great Britain, having lost to Turkey, could go above them in the standings to take forward to the second round if they can get the win at home and Newcastle, which has become a bit of a fortress for Great Britain. Turkey, though, have every big gun you can. But meanwhile, let's take a look at the best plays of the second half. And the consistency you'll see in the best plays at the Greek end of the floor is that they got shots they wanted out of things they ran, or they got things off their defense. They really didn't have to make great plays, they made great decisions. And It was just an exceptional third quarter. 30-10. They outscored Great Britain in quarter three. The pressure. That the guards put on Great Britain really did wear out. And again, because Great Britain did it, most of it on the dribble, that pressure was always be able to focus on the ball. And Greece just ran body after body after body at the guards in the backcourt. Exceptional performance by Greece. For Great Britain, Whelan was Whelan and Wheatle in the backcourt. Neither would class themselves as national team point guards. Did an exceptional job for most of the game. They really did work incredibly hard to take care of the basketball. Whelan and Wheatle had good games, but not the options. Did Olusani get as much of the basketball as he should? Well, with the issues in the backcourt, not surprising he didn't. But Greece just made Great Britain work for every single one of the 71 points that they had. Greece are always a contender. And with some of the players not playing in this game to come in, they're going to be a contender again. Tremendous performance by them. What a night it's been for the crowd in Larissa. They've enjoyed every second. Greece get the win. It's a big result that takes them to the top of Group B. Played 4-3-1 record, 7 points. They will take the best record out of this group forward and at least be no worse and level with the winner of Group A that they cross over with. Great performance by Greece. Stay tuned for more World Cup action across the world in the next few days. We'll see you soon for more. But for now, from Larissa, it's good. Bye.